Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Ragnarok Origin on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Ragnarok Origin and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5. Which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Ragnarok Origin. So without further ado, let's get to it. First of all folks, to start we have to launch our main internet browser. We selected the one we use by default. Let's go to this URL I'm highlighting in green color. Now, you are able to discover on the screen of the PC. There is no need to type anything. Because I provided the clickable link in the description of this video and as well in the first pinned comment. We landed here on the website of Usitility, at which we find here a meticulous outline on the best way to obtain Ragnarok Origin on computer. We scroll down a little bit and just click on the Download Game on PC button. After clicking on the link, we arrive here on the website of BlueStacks. No panic. It is simply the Android emulator that we are going to run to enjoy the game Ragnarok Origin on the PC. It is now obvious that we have several pros of preferring using that emulator. Now we will start downloading the Ragnarok Origin by clicking on this button play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green color. We then click on it. And the download takes no time at all. Here it is. Here is located the download. It is a file we have to execute. What we are going to do is to run the installer. Okay, then we have to click on this file. If we are on Windows 10, it will have asked us for permission to make modifications to the computer. We have clicked yes. I minimize the browser to find the installer considerably better. The installer is very easy to use. It contains two possibilities, install and setup path. I will make it clear what setup path does indeed. We simply just click it. So we see that we end up with here the path where the emulator can be set up. If we would you like to modify this folder, we have got to click on this browse button. So we opt for another folder and set up the emulator specifically where we want. To keep it simple, just set it as it is. Then, I click on back. So I click on install. Voila! The installation begins and it's going to go forward in the download of all these megabytes that happens to be shown on that screen. The moment you download it, it might possibly be slightly more or less MB. The download speed could go at a higher speed or slower, determined by your web access and according to the efficiency of the emulator hosting servers. Right now they are running rather fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At this moment, the emulator has been started immediately. As you can observe, down here, there's a progress bar that will fill up and once it has reached the finish, the emulator is started for the very first time. The truth is the emulator has already been started. Here for the very first time. Before we carry on, as you can discover, it has made two app icons there on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks software icon will be one we are considering. At any time when we would like to start Ragnarok Origin on the laptop or computer, we double-click that software icon and therefore launch the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Why don't we do the following step? That is a must-have, and this is to visit the Google Play Store. And we'll click on Play Store. As you can observe, the Google Play is launched. Right here we must log on. At this point when we're there, we must absolutely execute this following step that is definitely imperative. Therefore we click on Sign In. At this moment it says, checking info. It could in some cases get stopped at checking info, that's why it fails to progress. If that's the case, you can attempt to log in and after a number of hours it's going to usually be resolved. At this moment we are going to insert our email and password. The email address really needs to be a Gmail email address as well as its matching password. For instance, you may use the same exact email you're using at this moment in your own YouTube account. So I will submit my information and I'll come back immediately after I have accomplished it. That's it, data typed in. And here is Google welcoming us and presenting us their twos. We can consent to all of them simply by clicking on, I agree. Following, it offers us to save to the Google Cloud. You could keep it selected and this will build a backup of your files on this device to Google Drive. I am not going to check it, you do what you want. We click accept. Google Play Store is launched automatically and immediately. To set up the application, we would need to visit the emulator desktop for Android by simply clicking that icon indicated green colored. Right now that we are on the desktop of this Android emulator, we can see that we find there the install application option. We simply click on that button. There we have the game app. Let's quickly then click now on the install choice that I am presenting now in green color. And this will start the software installation. At present it is going to download on your laptop or computer and set up the video game. It can take quite some time or it could be amazingly quickly. It again all varies on our own internet access. It has as of now ended installing. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by clicking on this particular button I'm emphasizing in green, if you want to run Ragnarok Origin for the very first time. We're already on the emulator desktop, and therefore we are on the way to just click the brand new Ragnarok Origin software icon that was generated. This game is started for the first time. Here we end up with it. I am able to press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I should comment on the volume level of this emulator. This is right here. We use the icon of higher volume and also the icon of lower volume. This manner we do not rely on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound experience of your emulator. And to enjoy the experience to the maximum, we could activate the large monitor, for which we have two choices. This is the first one. We just click on that app icon which I'm showing in green color. And the screen is maximized, offering one border on top, one on the right side and one at the bottom. In the event that we desire to have fun with the video game using all the screen, we hit that game icon. Then we would at present be experiencing the gameplay in 100% screen function. To get out of the complete screen setting, click the F11 key. And we might now end up being in standard display screen setting. At present, I am going to demonstrate to you the computer keyboard mapping and that is certainly surprisingly enjoyable. That strategy we may be able to operate the game application far more effortlessly. The first thing is to mouse click this software icon. It's now time to get the required setups. I'll go ahead and let the standard settings. However, if you wish to change this, you may very well do this without having problem. Clearly, the emulator is completely in our own language. Occasionally it occurs that your emulator is presented in the incorrect language, such as in Japanese. And then to set it in the proper language we click here to the cogwheel. Then here inside of additional configuration settings, we just click the language drop down. We are able to pick the language we wish, Italian, Japanese, etc. As soon as the language is determined, we are going to save, the emulator will reboot, and the game app, next time we run it, will also be in the preferred language. At this point, there is another information that we will need to take into consideration, and this is that we will get a message from Google Mail reporting that a completely new machine has been connected to this Google account. It will likely check with us if we're the individuals who have connected that electronic device. Yup, we must not be troubled, since the emulator is behaving like an Google Android tablet or smartphone. In order to see which smartphone or tablet is being emulated, we visit right here, to the cogwheel and we mouse click on it. Therefore we go here to the model choice. And right here we learn that the emulator is simulating a Samsung smartphone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all folks, so much for that training. I hope that you appreciated it, especially that you thought it was informative. In that case, give it a superb thumb up, subscribe, and any feedback, questions or ideas, put them in the comment field down below. You may also leave comments on my Twitch channel. I conduct live streams ever so often. You get it down below in the video description and in the very first pinned comment. Simply click any of the instructional videos that are appearing on the computer screen and let's have fun again in the future video tutorials. Bye.